All right, hello everyone. Welcome to Ocean View number 3. This is my monthly podcast thingamajig that I do. And August was pretty busy IRL wise for me. I went on vacation and I was just doing a lot of other stuff, trying to get some stuff going for my future, kind of. But there was also a lot of games, and maybe not a lot of games, but there's a lot of movies and TV shows and entertainment, like, that sort of entertainment that I watched. So I'm going to be getting into all that today. This might be a little bit long, like the first one, maybe not, but I'll try to make it shorter if it gets too long. I'll see. So the topics for today are the Destiny 2 PC beta and the Injustice 2 Fighter Pack 2 that got announced. That those will be the new fighter DLC characters that are going to be in the game. And that's about all I have for the games of August. Like I said, I mean, it wasn't too much for games, but both of those things are pretty big since I'm going to be playing a lot of Destiny 2. And I've been playing Injustice 2 pretty often since it came out back in May, I think. Pretty sure it was May. I don't remember. I think it was May. But yeah, those are two of the big games that I'm kind of playing at the moment, so those are important at the moment. And then in terms of movies and TV, there was The Defenders, the Marvel Netflix shows all coming together, like The Avengers. There was a new YouTuber that I found. His name is Captain Christian. I'll talk about how he's relevant to myself later on. And then Spawn, the movie and the TV show, those will also be sort of relevant to Captain Christian in a way. Those all kind of have something like do with each other. They all kind of like intertwine. And then the other like normal TV, I watched all the Rick and Morty episodes that came out in August, and there was about 4, I think. 4 out of the like 10 episodes that are coming. I'm pretty sure it ends in September or the beginning of October, so I'll probably talk about the rest of those next month. And then in my last Ocean View, I'm pretty sure I was talking about how Game of Thrones had just come back on and everybody was freaking out about Game of Thrones and how everybody loved it. So I actually started watching it and I finished the whole thing. I am completely caught up now, so I'm going to talk about some of the memorable things, like some of the big things that happened, and then I'll talk about Season 7. And then the bigger thing that I'll be talking about, I guess, because it took up like almost 2 weeks of the month for me, is my vacation. I went on a trip to New York to visit family and do touristy stuff, and I have a lot of pictures and stuff, so I'll probably be looking at those and talking about like each day, because I went with my parents and we kind of had like a set schedule, so we got to do a lot of things in a short amount of time and it was pretty enjoyable. So I'll be talking about that at the end, and then at the very end I'll be talking about personal stuff with me, like with my channel and content and all that. So with that being said, I guess we'll start off with the games section. And the first thing I'll talk about is the Destiny 2 PC beta. I played the PS4 beta. I talked about that in my last Ocean View. The PC beta was as I expected. I mean, it was the same thing as the PS4 beta. It was just the first mission of the story, the strike, and two multiplayer game modes, two PvP game modes. But the difference was it was on PC, so it was, you know, 1080p, 60fps. It looked fucking amazing. The graphics were beautiful. The 60fps was like, I can't even, like, it was so smooth. It was so, oh, so perfect. Like, it's so good. I really wish that PC didn't get delayed like it did. Or it didn't really get delayed, but they're just choosing to release it later so they can perfect it, which is admirable, but I still wish it was out now, because I'm gonna be playing it on PS4, but man, I want to play PC so bad. It just feels so good. It feels like that's how Destiny should have felt from the beginning. I feel If it was on PC for the first game, I feel like people would have loved the game more than they did. But it feels great on PC. I played the first mission and everything. I played all three of the characters again. Each character felt pretty good. I like how the mouse and keyboard controls work. They're not super complicated, but they're not like... I mean, the game itself on consoles was already... It wasn't super complicated, but it's got some mechanics that you kind of have to... Like, if you learn them, if you get the muscle memory for them, then they'll definitely... Like, you'll be better if you remember how to do everything. And it took, like, I mean, it took a little bit of getting used to, because nobody's ever used a keyboard and mouse for Destiny. But it felt good once I got used to it. So I think the controls work pretty well. And there's, you can change the key bindings and everything. I changed a couple of them. So that possibility is there for you, or that option is there for you, if you want to change the controls, if you don't like the default ones, which aren't too bad. Some of them are kind of weird and awkward. Like, I think the mic was like Alt and Tilde, so it's kind of weird. Mic isn't usually a two-button like command, but whatever. Again, you can change everything. And yeah, I mean, I think you should definitely play it on PC if you can. It's like hands down the best on PC. Like, I've played the beta on both PS4 and PC. I haven't played the full game on PS4. It's out at the time I'm recording this. I'm actually recording this the day it came out, and I haven't played it yet. But I know that it's better on PC. It's kind of obvious after playing both, and everybody else agrees that played the PC. So if you can, you should probably try to play it on PC. If not, it's still enjoyable on consoles. So also, this time I actually played some PvP. I didn't really get a chance to play it on PS4. Also, I didn't really want to play it. I'm probably not even going to play it like in the full game when I get it, because I mean, I'm not very good at aiming with a controller in first person games, and I think I'm even less, like, I've lost what little skills I had now since I've been playing on PC for about a year and a half. Like, I played on PC before when I had consoles, but since I got my good computer like about a year and a half actually, I've been playing more on PC than I've been getting used to PC, and it's much better than a controller. So I played PvP on PC because I knew I would be slightly better. I'm still not, you know, I wasn't amazing, but it was a lot easier to play and a lot more enjoyable. And I actually enjoyed the PvP a little bit. There was the control point game mode, which is pretty much the same as the first game. It's just like A, B, and C point that you have to capture, and it's nothing too special. And then they had another game mode, which was Countdown. That's a new game mode. It's pretty similar to like a CSGO kind of game mode, where, you know, you have to plant a bomb or something. I'm pretty sure they had something that was kind of like that in the first game. It was kind of like a capture the flag, but it was like a ball that you smashed down. Smashed that motherfucking, like, yeah. But, Countdown was pretty fun, and it's definitely better if you have a full team that can communicate with each other. I played with two of my friends, and we did decent most of the time. But it's probably better, like, if you play with a full team with three people, because each game mode only has four players, which is kind of weird for a game like that. You'd expect it to have a little bit more. Pretty sure it used to be six in the first game. But I think four works because you could have smaller teams and you can communicate better, I think. Four is a pretty good, like, average number for multiplayer games, I think. Also, it was kind of weird. I think it's better if you have people that you can play with, because it's kind of weird. A lot of people didn't have mics for some reason. I had a feeling like maybe they got PCs and hadn't played a lot on PC, and they played Destiny on console, and then when they moved over to PC, like, you know, maybe they don't know how to use PCs that well. They just got it because they wanted to play games, but they're not a pro at using it yet. So maybe they just don't have a mic. I don't know. That was kind of weird. Like, basically, nobody had a mic that we played with, which was strange. But that's yet another reason why you should probably try to play with people that you know and can talk to on like Discord or something. And besides that, there's not really much else to talk about in the beta. Like I said, I mean, the game is out today. I'm recording it on the 6th. I'll be playing it on the 8th, this Friday. Possibly with friends or possibly by myself. But either way, the full game is out now. So there's not too much else to talk about. Like, about the beta. Because that's over. And you could see the full game now if you wanted to. Like, there's people who have already beaten the game. Because they got it yesterday, early, like, review copies. So, not too much else to say that I didn't say in the PS4 beta thing of last month, or that you can't go look at right now. But it's very enjoyable. Destiny 2 on PC, it's so good, honestly. It's made for PC, I think. Like, Destiny should have been on PC from the beginning. And, I'm very excited to play it on PC, but that doesn't come out till the 24th of October, so it's almost like 2 months. We gotta wait all of September and basically all of October. So, I can't wait, and some of my friends already have it on PS4, so I will be getting it on PS4 when I can, this Friday. So I'll be streaming. I'm kind of gonna talk about that later, although I kind of just talked about it now. But, yeah, that'll come later at the end. But, yeah. Destiny 2, good. And then the next gaming-related thing that happened that was big for me in August was they announced the Fighter Pack 2 of Injustice 2. They announced 3 new fighters. There are gonna be 3 fighter packs in total. They already had one already, which was Red Hood, Sub-Zero, and Starfire. Those are the characters. They're all in the game now. And the next one that they're going to release is going to have Black Manta, Raiden, and Hellboy. Black Manta, they've already showed gameplay for, and he's not like a super popular character, but his gameplay does look pretty cool and interesting. And I know a little bit about him, but not too much. And they probably won't talk about... I mean, they usually don't talk about, like... They have little, like, things that they say at the beginning of the matches, but there's not a lot of lore or anything in there. That's what the comic books are for. But Black Manta does seem pretty cool. I'm excited to try him out. And he's, like I said, he's going to be the first character that's released. They've already showed gameplay for him. I believe he comes out in September. Probably actually, like, next week or 2 weeks from now when I'm recording this. Because I think it's usually like the second week of every month when they release a character. So I guess we'll see. They might have a date already. I guess I could actually look that up real quick. Okay. So yeah, it says next week, September 12th, I believe, is when it said. I don't know if that's the exact date, but that's when Black Manta should come out. And then that means the following month will probably be Raiden in October. It's the Raiden from Mortal Kombat. The same people who make Mortal Kombat are making, or they made Injustice 2. So, they're gonna put a couple Mortal Kombat characters in there. They put Scorpion in the first game, and they already have Sub-Zero in the second one. Me and a lot of other people are kind of like disappointed that they're having another Mortal Kombat character when they could have another guest character, or they could have just another DC character. But I'm sure he'll be okay. I mean, he looks kind of cool, I guess. I'm not really super excited about Black Manta and Raiden, but I am very excited about Hellboy, who is a kind of a surprise guest character. They already said that they're going to have a couple guest characters. A lot of people are speculating that Spawn would be in the game, or maybe a Watchmen character, since in the comics right now, Watchmen are kind of like a big thing in the DC universe, at least Dr. Manhattan is. And a lot of people are kind of expecting that another guest character will be in Fighter Pack 3, and that might be a Watchmen character. I'm really hoping that it will be, because I'd love to see a Watchmen character. It could be Rorschach or Dr. Manhattan, or even maybe like Night Owl. That wouldn't be too bad. So I'm excited to see who that would be, but Hellboy, I did not expect at all, honestly. I thought it was going to be like Spawn or somebody, or just maybe another cool DC character, but I did not expect Hellboy to be in it. And I'm pretty excited about that because Hellboy is pretty cool and he's not, I don't think he has a lot of games really. I don't know if I've ever seen a game. He might have had one for the movies that came out. They might have made some bad movie tie-in game. But I'm pretty interested to see what they do with him in the game. Because the main part of Injustice 2 is you get gear that changes your appearance for every character. And Hellboy doesn't usually have a lot of like different outfits really. Or costumes or anything. He usually has like shirt and pants and like a trench coat. And he's got his big fist. I'm wondering if they're going to... They'll probably like give him a different gun and stuff. Or different jacket and stuff. I'm interested to see what they do with him. Because like I said, he doesn't really have a lot of different costumes. He just usually wears the same one. Also, I'm excited to see his gameplay. Because it will probably be pretty cool. I think it'll probably be a combo of like... combination of like his... his big fist and his guns and everything. So I'm excited to see how Hellboy plays out. And I guess he'll probably be in November. Since they usually release a character every month. So that'll be pretty cool. I might talk about each character in future Ocean Views. If I think that really warrants it. So keep an eye out for that. Injustice 2 is a pretty cool game too. If you haven't played it yet, you should try it out. It's probably going to be like going on sale at some point soon because it's been out for a couple months. So if it ever goes on sale, you should definitely check it out. Also, whenever it comes on PC, I'm probably going to get it again. And yeah, if it comes out on PC, you guys should check it out because it's a pretty fun fighting game. And I think it's pretty easy to get into because I'm usually not very good at fighting games, but I think I'm decent-ish at Injustice. It's pretty easy to learn, I think. So that'll be about it for the game section of this. Like I said, there wasn't too much going on, but there were quite a few movie TV related things that I watched this month. And I'll talk about the first thing I'll talk about is the Defenders, because they were kind of like, the Defenders is kind of on its own. All the other stuff that I'm talking about kind of intertwines with something. But I've never really talked about the Netflix Marvel shows at all. And I was also pretty excited for The Defenders. I've been waiting for it since Daredevil, which came out in 2015. Because I knew I was gonna watch the Marvel Netflix shows before, like when they announced them. But I didn't think I would like them as much as I do, and I did like them a lot. I've pretty much watched all of them the day they came out. I binged the whole thing, and I really enjoyed that. It was kind of just like a longer Marvel movie. And this is, The Defenders is the team-up show of all the Netflix Marvel shows that they have at the moment, which is Daredevil, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage, and Iron Fist. They are the four people who make up the Defenders, and there was a lot of the side characters from each of their individual shows, because they all had individual shows. So there's a lot of their side characters that were all in there, and I enjoyed that part of it. It all kind of gave them... even if it was a little something, it gave them a little something to do, you know. It was like, they might not have had a big part like Colleen Wing or Claire, because she's kind of the one who brings them all together in a way. I mean, she knows all of them. She's met all of them. So some of them had big roles like them. Some of them were just kind of on the side, but I enjoyed seeing them there. And it's been building up since 2015. I didn't think it would be as monumental as the Avengers, but it was about as good as I expected it to be. I wasn't expecting it to be bad, obviously, because most of the shows have been pretty good except Iron Fist, and I liked Iron Fist for the most part. Some of it wasn't the best. A lot of people said Iron Fist was the worst though, and they like really shit on it. I don't think it deserved that, but I knew the Defenders wouldn't be bad like that, because all the other characters are pretty established and good. But again, yeah, I also wasn't expecting it to be as good as the movies in the MCU. I liked all their relationships that were formed between the characters. It was a little bit more believable than the Avengers, because like some of the Defenders wanted to be heroes, like Luke Cage and Iron Fist. They wanted to help people. And then some of them didn't want to be anymore for personal things that happened in their seasons, like Jessica Jones and Daredevil. And I think that's different than the Avengers, because the Avengers all had reasons to become the Avengers, and they were already kind of superheroes before superheroes were a thing in the MCU. So they kind of had, it's kind of like they had an obligation to be the Avengers. They were kind of forced to do it in a way. But the Defenders, they kind of had a choice, and they had more, since it was in episodes, they had more time to think about it, I guess. The Avengers got to think about it, but they knew they had to, they were the only ones who could stop what was happening in the movie. And at the end of the Defenders, they kind of realized that too. But they, I feel like they had more of a choice. And I think at one point, I mean, some, like Jessica Jones left at one point and kind of went off on her own. So I just feel like there was a lot more personal bonding and separation, and a lot of them working together and figuring each other out than in the Avengers. Although again, the Avengers was a 2-hour movie. The Defenders was an 8-episode TV show, so they had a lot more time to develop all that stuff. Also, they're probably going to keep developing it, just like they do with the Avengers in the movies. Also, I feel like they kind of made the Defenders seem a little more like normal people, because some of them are kind of normal people, like Daredevil and Iron Fist. I mean, they know martial arts, and Iron Fist has his giant glowing hand, and Daredevil can hear, and, you know, his senses are heightened, but they're almost normal people. The Avengers, they all have pretty, you know, unique things about them. And even though, like, Iron Man, he's just in a suit of armor, and Captain America is basically super strong, they're still kind of larger than life heroes. The Defenders are kind of more like street level heroes, so I feel like you kind of connect to them a little bit more than the Avengers. All the action in the show was pretty great, considering that they all had like unique fighting styles, and I felt that the 8 episodes were pretty good compared to the normal 13, because sometimes it felt like there was a lot of filler in the 13 episodes. The 8 episodes are pretty good. There was kind of the build up to them becoming a team, and then there was the overall problem, which was the Hand, who have been in the other shows. They're like the Japanese mafia kind of thing. But actually, they're not Japanese. They're all over the world. They were kind of trying to show that in the show. They're kind of everywhere. And they kind of just got to the point that they had to stop them. And like they understood that they were the only people who could stop them. And then they stopped them. So it kind of got to the point there wasn't a lot of filler stuff in the show. Overall, I thought it was quite enjoyable, and I'd love to see this Netflix universe grow bigger and better with the shows that they continue to add. Like, one that we already know is coming up is The Punisher. I'm hoping that will build on the universe and maybe reference or hint at what happened in The Defenders, maybe. Also, I'd love to see the shows cross over into the movies. I always wanted to see that since Daredevil, I thought, because Daredevil came out right before the second Avengers movie, and I thought it would be cool to see Daredevil crossover. And since they kept introducing Defenders, I kept wanting them all to be in the movies at some point if they can be. So hopefully that'll happen in the future, because the MCU is probably going to keep making movies for a long, long time. They're probably not going to stop for a while, because they just keep making money, so they'll keep making movies. Alright, so the next thing I'm going to talk about is actually a YouTube channel, another YouTube channel on this fine and dandy website of YouTube. His name is Captain Christian. He makes video essay kind of videos. I believe that's what I've seen somebody call them, or maybe he called them that, but it's kind of hard to explain them. I don't know if I'm going to put up some of his videos, in the edit. I'm definitely gonna show or link his channel in the description. But I mean, basically what he does is he just talks about a number of different topics. Like he's talked about the sound design in Star Wars, and he's talked about Batman, like just Batman in general, the animated series and his movies. He's talked about the Superman cartoon and everything. And then he's also talked about gorillas and Childish Gambino and other musical artists. And he talks about a lot of different topics, and he makes them interesting and entertaining. It's kind of like a documentary in a way, but the editing is very just, I mean, to me it's profound, and I love how he edits everything together. Because in my little experience of editing, I've kind of, I could see the stuff on its own. I could see the like pictures and the music and everything. I could see it on its own, and I could see how he blends it together. And it, I wish I could do it like he does, because it's just, it's fantastic how he blends everything together and makes it coherent and understandable and interesting all at the same time. Like, also, it's pretty short too. Like, he makes short-ish videos, but they take a long time to make, and that's kind of my dream in a way. I mean, at least at the moment. I don't know if I want to do that for my whole life, but I would like to at least try to make one video like that, like he does. Yeah, I mean, I'd just like to make one video at least if I could, like that. And he makes videos like that every month or every couple of months. So, he's a new YouTuber that I found, and I really appreciate his work. And you should definitely go check him out. It's far better than my content. But hopefully I'll get to that point. That is kind of my goal, to make quality content that is also entertaining and interesting in some way. And then that kind of leads into my next topic. One of the things that he talked about in one of his videos was Spawn, the comic book character. And I didn't know too much about Spawn. I've heard about Spawn, and I think I've seen parts of the movie, and I didn't remember it all. So I actually went and watched the movie from the 90s, because it was on Netflix. And I was like, sure, I guess I'll watch this, because it's only like an hour and a half. It's not super long. But I want to watch it, because I learned a little bit more about Spawn from Captain Christian's videos. And now I'm going to talk about the Spawn movie, which was not very good, honestly. It wasn't a terrible movie, but it was definitely not one of the best. The cinematography is decent, I think. Like, all the shots and everything are pretty decent for the kind of movie that it is. And I think the acting is also kind of, like, decent, but not the best. Neither is the writing. I mean, I think a lot of the characters, a lot of the actors did pretty well. Martin Sheen is in it. He's a pretty great actor. John Leguizamo is in it. They all do a pretty good job, but just the lines and the writing honestly isn't the best, I don't think. It feels like it's very 90s. Like, it's pretty cheesy and kind of edgy. And like at the very beginning, the intro is just some punk like metal kind of song. I don't know, it's very 90s. It's kind of hard to explain, but if you know what I'm talking about, then you'll understand. It's a very specific kind of thing, and it's understandable why it's like that. Also, the CGI was not very good at all. There's like this one, like, I don't remember his name, but I'm pretty sure he's basically like the devil or Satan, and whenever they show him, it's pretty bad. It is not very good at all. I'll probably show you, like, whenever they go to hell at some point, it just does not look very good at all. And also, I felt like the plot wasn't really explained that well. I mean, I understood what was going on, and I understood the point of the movie. It was kind of that Spawn was reborn because he was killed, and then he was reborn as a hell spawn, and the devil wanted to use him to take over the world. But I don't know, it just felt like there was a lot of small stuff that was kind of meaningless. Even though it was an hour and a half, it felt like some parts dragged on. Like, at the end of the movie, I kind of stopped paying attention, to be honest. I was on my phone a little bit. So, I felt like it could have been better, like plot wise and writing wise and all that. Maybe a little bit easier to understand. One thing I did like, though, I'm kind of shitting on the movie, but I did like Spawn's suit. It looked pretty cool. It looked pretty decent for the rest of the movie. I thought it was pretty cool, and it looked pretty close to the comic books. Although, he didn't really have his cape the entire time, which was kind of weird, because the cape is kind of like one of his main things. But most of the time, his cape would just like pop on his back whenever he's doing something, and then it wouldn't, like, it would just go away. I don't know, it's kind of weird. And the ending of the movie was also pretty messy CGI wise. It was in hell, and there was CGI monsters and just a whole lot of shit, honestly. It's a whole lot of mess on the screen. So, and like, at the end of it, I mean, it's not the worst movie, but it's definitely not very good.
Hello, I just want to make a quick little addendum. If you actually listened to all of that, what I just said about Spawn, and got to this point, I just want to like save my reputation a little bit. Back when I recorded this, it was 6 years ago. I'm editing this. I'm recording this audio currently in 2023. So I was 20 years old when I watched Spawn, and I was trying to be like nice about it and be like, oh, yeah, some stuff was good. I've actually taken film classes and started to understand the craft a little more. I'm definitely still not an expert, but I can for sure say that Spawn is ass, and it is very shitty. I was just looking at these clips that I edited into this video, and yeah, it is disgusting to look at. I was talking about something like the cinematography was good or something. It's not. It's just all fake and a mess, and it's just, yeah, it looks like a video game. It's bad. I haven't watched a movie since 2017, so I don't have like an updated view, but just from looking at this, I know that it's a shit movie. So, just wanted to make sure that you know that I'm not still a dumbass 6 years later.
After watching the movie, I remembered that there's a HBO, like, cartoon TV series, or animated TV series on HBO, like I said. And the TV show works better, at least from what I've watched. I only watched the first episode, but I think it worked way better than the movie just in the first episode. It explains everything like the movie tried to, but in the movie there was like weird flashbacks. The TV show showed the flashbacks in Spawn's head, and like it showed him dealing with them. In the movie, it was kind of the clown was kind of making fun of Spawn and kind of being crude about his flashbacks, and it just didn't really feel like it was working that well. But in the TV show, you know, it's a lot more emotional. I think it shows his like personal connection. It wasn't trying to be funny and like edgy like the movie was trying to be. And yeah, the show kind of feels more personal. Like you kind of feel what Spawn's going through without them having to explain a whole lot. And they might explain a lot later on. It's about 3 seasons, I'm pretty sure. And like I said, I only watched the first episode, but I thought, I mean, it was explained better than the movie was, I thought. And I'll probably watch the rest of it at some point if I can, and I might talk about it again, but I just wanted a quick touch on that. Because, like I said, Captain Christian kind of introduced me to more of Spawn. Like I said, I knew who he was before. I believe I've seen parts of the movie, and that was when I was younger, so I probably thought it was good back then, but now I realize that it's definitely not. But I just liked seeing the difference between the TV show and the movie. And I may read the comics someday if I get a chance, because I'm sure the comics are probably the best form of Spawn that they have. Also, hopefully, like I was saying, for Injustice, maybe he'll be in Injustice. Or he might be in the next Mortal Kombat game, because a lot of people were saying they would rather him in the next Mortal Kombat. Because in Mortal Kombat, they have fatalities, and it can be very violent, and Spawn's pretty violent, so probably be better if he's in that. That'll pretty much do it for Spawn and Captain Christian. That was just a little something that I kind of was interested in after my trip. Now, I'll talk about the TV show that I've been watching every week, which is Rick and Morty. Like I said, the new episodes are back, and they're happening weekly. And all of the new episodes have been pretty great so far, actually. They've been consistently good, I think. The Pickle Rick episode was probably one of the best episodes of the show like, overall, it had the most of the family, excluding Jerry, they were all in therapy, which was funny, but it was also important to the story because it was kind of detailing how they all felt after their parents got divorced in, I think it was the beginning of season 3. And then the other half of the episode was Rick as a pickle, which was extremely funny, and I thought it was extremely well animated because he was a pickle, but he got like rat body parts and stuff, and he became like mobile, and he was like doing a bunch of crazy shit as a pickle. And I thought it was really well done because he was doing a lot of intricate things in such a short amount of time, and you could tell what's going on, but if you go back and look, I'm sure you can catch something new every couple of times. You'll see that scene or see all the scenes that he's in as a pickle. So I thought that was a very good episode overall. The Vindicators episode was next, and that was also pretty good. It introduced a lot of new characters that were pretty cool, even though they were only there. Well, some of them were only there for a short amount of time. It kind of reminded me of the Anatomy Park episode. I think that was I'm pretty sure that was in season 1. In that episode, there was also a lot of, it was like a group of people who were slowly dying throughout the episode. Some of them were dying in, you know, specific ways, and that kind of happened with the Vindicators episode too. But I just really like how they can keep making all these unique characters for the show that could, you know, they could be there in one episode for a second and then die, or they could just become sort of main characters and they can be there for a couple episodes later on, or and you'll remember them, and they could have a bigger role than they were originally seen to have. The next episode was the Rick and Jerry episode. I thought that episode was a nice change of pace because Rick was still the main character pretty much, but Morty was kind of a background character this time, and that was interesting to see because he was just dealing with his family that isn't Rick, which he usually doesn't have to do. He's usually just stuck with Rick. It's also cool to see Jerry do a little bit more, and kind of it was nice to see the changing like emotions between him and Rick, even though Rick basically like ruined Jerry's life because he kind of forced Beth in a way to get a divorce with Jerry. But I liked that episode overall. Well, also they went to a pretty cool place. I don't remember where it was at, but that like place where they couldn't die or whatever, that was pretty cool. I liked that part. And then the most recent episode was the toxic like Rick and Morty episode where they went to a spa and they got the toxicity out of them, which turned out to be like an entire other part of them. So they were kind of split into two parts. And I thought that was a pretty good episode. I liked that the confident Morty was like pretty different from the normal Morty. And it was kind of cool, again, how they do a lot of different things in just one episode in Rick and Morty. Because they had all the toxic stuff in the beginning, and then they had Rick, and well, Morty was kind of off on his own, like he became like a Wall Street broker or something, like he was like doing a whole bunch of stuff in just that one episode. So yeah, all the episodes recently have been pretty enjoyable, and I'm looking forward to the last couple episodes, and it's gonna suck again when we gotta wait a while for season 4, but hopefully it won't be as long as last time. And then I think I said this at the beginning, I talked about Game of Thrones in my last Ocean View, talking about how it was coming back and everybody was freaking out about it and they were saying how good it was, and I decided to finally catch up on Game of Thrones. I want to talk about some of the memorable moments, like the Red Wedding, which I had already gotten spoiled for that. Like, I got it spoiled for a lot of stuff, like Red Wedding, Jon Snow dies, Joffrey dying, Arya went blind. Like, I got spoiled for quite a bit. But stuff like the Red Wedding, it was still pretty impactful because, you know, you'd been watching 3 seasons and you'd been kind of getting a connection to Rob and his mom and everything, Catelyn Stark. So it was not very fun to watch that, especially watching a pregnant woman get stabbed in the stomach multiple times. That wasn't very cool. Pretty fucked up. But it was well done, I guess, even though it was fucked up. One thing that was fucked up but enjoyable was Joffrey dying. I was so excited when that happened. I fucking hated Joffrey, just like I'm sure everybody who watched the show did. And I was very happy when he died. And it's also pretty good. Like, it's, you gotta give credit to the actor, because I've actually seen, like, I've seen a couple of interviews with the actor, and he seems like a pretty cool guy in real life. And it's great that he can go from that to being a hateable, like, shitty child who everybody who watches the show hates. So you gotta give credit to him. He did an excellent job of acting that character out. And then there was a part with Tyrion's, like, trial that he had, because everybody thought that he killed Joffrey, even though it was Olenna, the Lady Tyrell. So, yeah, that was pretty good, because Tyrion was kind of... He had some memorable things that he did in that. And then there was the part where he killed Shay, which I didn't know that happened, and I really didn't expect that to happen. And then he killed Tywin. I heard the Tywin die, but I didn't know that Tyrion killed him. And on the toilet is pretty crazy, that part. Also, actually, now that I think about it, I think it was the episode before that. Because I'm pretty sure that was season 4 finale. But the episode before that, season 4, episode 9, was... I believe that was the battle at Castle Black, which was the battle between the Night's Watch and the Wildlings, and I thought that was really great. It was like a whole episode just dedicated to that battle, and I thought it was very well done. I liked all the different emotions, because there was stuff with Sam and stuff with Jon and Ygritte, and there was just a whole lot of stuff going on in that one episode, and I thought it was pretty good. And then there was the season 5 finale with Jon Snow's death. I actually didn't know how he died. I knew that he died. I got spoiled for that. But I didn't know how he died, and it was actually a lot shittier than I thought. I thought he, like, got killed by a White Walker or something, but his own men killed him. Which I did not know that happened, and that was pretty fucked up. And then when he came back to life, he had to hang the people who did it, and one of them was Ollie, the kid. So that was pretty fucked up. But, I mean, I guess he had to do that. And then another thing involving Jon Snow at the end of season 6 was the Battle of the Bastards, which is fucking... That was a great episode. I thought it was going to be like the Castle Black battle, where it was just like a whole episode of the fight. But there was a little bit more stuff going on in that episode, but I appreciated that. And the battle itself was just amazing. And I was very happy with the ending where Ramsay got killed, because Ramsay was also a shitter, like Joffrey. And it was cool that he got killed by his dog, so he killed a bunch of people with. It was very poetic. I liked that part. And then the other thing that happened in the finale was Cersei fucking going Heisenberg when she blew up the entire church or whatever. Those everybody was in it. It was the Tyrells and the Faith Militants, I believe, or something. I don't remember their name exactly, but I think that's what they're called. The crazy religious people. And I actually, when I was watching that episode, it was pretty funny, because I actually didn't get spoiled on that at all. I did not know that happened at all. Like I said, I got spoiled by a lot of stuff, but I did not know that happened. And when I saw all the people in there, I was thinking, alright, so Cersei's probably gonna kill her, because they were showing her like off on her own. So I was thinking, she's probably gonna kill them all. What's she gonna do? Is she gonna send the mountain in there? Is she gonna have like a bunch of people slit their throats or something? And I actually thought to myself before I saw what happened, I thought, man, it'd be good because she could just knock everybody out. She could just blow them up or something, but she can't really do that. That's not something that could happen in Game of Thrones. And then the one guy, I think it was Lancel Lannister, he was in the underground, and then he saw the wildfire, and I was like, oh shit, she actually can blow everybody up. Holy fuck. Like, I did not know that happened, and I'm surprised that I got it. It was pretty funny, I thought. Also, that was definitely some Heisenberg shit that she did. That was exactly something that Heisenberg from Breaking Bad would do. He kind of already did that. It was the part in season 5 where he was at his house and all the people got killed in jail. And he was just sitting there, so Cersei was on some Heisenberg shit in that episode, which I thought was pretty funny. And then season 7, the current season, or the last season, I guess, there was a lot of different stuff that happened. Daenerys finally made it to Westeros. That was pretty cool, seeing her go there. And her and Jon Snow meeting was pretty cool. Also, it was nice to see Jon Snow as the King of the North. I like that part, even though Sansa's kind of the person in charge at the moment, or where we left off, even though I'm pretty sure Jon was going back there with Daenerys. Also, pretty much all the fights that happened in season 7 were fantastic. There was like the boat battle in the second episode. I thought that was pretty well done for it being so short. I thought it was very well done. And then in the fourth episode, I'm pretty sure that was the one with the dragon attack. I don't remember what it was called. I think I heard it was like attack on the war train or something like that. I don't remember exactly what it was called. But it was the fight where the Lannister army was trying to, I think they were trying to go back to King's Landing, and then Daenerys' dragon came and fucked everything up, and so did the Dothraki. And that was just a beautiful battle. It was so well done. Everything was great. That's another thing I want to say too. The dragons' CGI and like the entire show has been pretty great. The dragons look pretty good. They look pretty realistic, or as realistic as they could, I'm guessing. And then there was the part towards the end of the season. It was the second to last episode where Jon Snow and everybody were stranded over in the middle of all the White Walkers, army of the dead. And that was pretty cool. I like when Daenerys came in and saved everybody. But I did not like when her dragon died. That was pretty sad, because those dragons have been around for pretty much the whole show, and one of them getting killed was pretty emotional. It was not cool, man. And then at the end, obviously, now the Night King has a dragon. He basically has Sindra Gosa from World of Warcraft, so. And then he knocked down the wall, so a lot of people are gonna get fucked. So I'm guessing the last season's probably just gonna be a big battle between everybody in the White Walkers. Because pretty much everybody's with Jon Snow now. Like, Daenerys and Jon Snow are together now. Jaime left Cersei and he's probably going to go join them, I'm guessing. I'm sure whoever else can fight will probably fight, except for Cersei. She's probably just going to be stupid on her own. But I'm excited to see what happens in Season 8. I'm glad that I finally caught up to the show. It was fun watching it. And I'm excited to see the last season. And now I'm going to get to the big thing that happened to me in August. Like I said, it wasn't a big thing, but you know, it took up a lot of my time and it was pretty fun. I enjoyed it. My vacation in New York. I actually didn't go to New York right away. Me and my parents went to Ohio for a couple days. We had some like kind of personal stuff that we were doing there. I felt like that wasn't as important as the New York stuff, or I enjoyed the New York stuff a lot more. One thing I could say about that though, when we were driving up there, because we drove, my dad can't really fly. I'm kind of scared of flying, but I can fly. He's the opposite, like he's not scared, but he really can't. It's something like his ears, like you know how your ears pop when you're on a plane or when you get into higher altitudes. Well, I think the same thing happens to my dad, but I'm pretty sure it's like physically painful, and I don't know if his ears start bleeding, but it's like it's pretty bad for him. So we can't fly. We had to drive up there to New York, and I live in New Orleans, so it's a pretty long drive. That's kind of another reason why we went to Ohio. We stopped there for a little bit before going to New York, and yeah, so I drove up first couple hundred miles. I drove for a couple hours the day we left. And once we stopped for lunch, I figured out that my phone camera, the back camera, was shattered somehow. I don't know how that happened. I put it down before I started driving, and then I looked at it, like I said, at lunch, and yeah, the camera was just fucking busted. So I had no idea what happened, but I couldn't use my camera for the first couple days because it was broken like that. However, the first day we got to New York on Monday, I kind of cleared some of the glass out because the glass was kind of like shoved into the camera, but I kind of cleared some of it out. So my camera started working after that, and I was very happy because I took a whole lot of pictures, and I'm glad that I could. If I didn't take any of these pictures, I feel like the trip would have been a little bit more boring. Or not boring, but it wouldn't have been as special, I think. So I don't know what the fuck happened to my camera, but I'm glad it worked. So Sunday was actually, well, we were staying in New Jersey with my godmother at her house because she has a pretty big house and she lives alone. So we were staying with her, and Sunday actually was the first day we kind of did something. It was kind of a family thing. We went to one of my mom's cousin's house, who has a big house like upstate New York, not in the city. And that's what we done on Sunday. It was pretty nice, although that was before my camera was fixed, so I didn't really get any pictures of that. But Monday was the first day we kind of did stuff. Again, I didn't get many pictures on Monday, but there wasn't much to take pictures of. Although my camera, like I said, my camera was working after, so I did get to test it out and make sure that it was working properly. And yeah, Monday was just kind of like a rainy day the whole day. We didn't really do much. We just ate some lunch. That's when we went to see Dunkirk. That's when I saw Dunkirk only the one time. I was planning on talking about it, but I don't remember too much of it because it was pretty good. But I mean, so much stuff happened on that trip, I kind of forgot about it, honestly. But I did really enjoy the movie. I thought it was one of Christopher Nolan's better movies. I don't think it's the best still. I think like Dark Knight and Interstellar and Inception are still better, I think. But Dunkirk was pretty good. I'd say check it out if you can. But that's all we did Monday. Monday wasn't too special. Tuesday was kind of the first time we did something special. We went to the beach. We went to Long Beach in New York. That's kind of outside the city. It's a beach kind of on Long Beach, which is the beach is Long Beach. It's on Long Island, which is a smaller little island kind of near New York. It's by Queens and Brooklyn and the smaller parts of New York City, not Manhattan. But I really liked the island. It was pretty nice. There was a lot of small, like, bungalow kind of houses, and there was like larger houses. They were all kind of close together, so I thought, I mean, it seemed pretty nice. It kind of seemed like a small little town, but it was kind of in between a town and a city in a way, and I liked the feel of it and the vibe of it. It was pretty nice. I enjoyed being there. I thought I might possibly go up there. Well, we went over there to visit my parents' friends, who actually, they live in New Orleans like me, but they live here in the winter because it's not super cold in the winter in New Orleans, but it's extremely cold in New York. Even near the beach, it's still cold in the winter. So they come down here for the winter and they stay at their beach house in the summer. So that's where we went on that day. And I was gonna say, I kind of would consider maybe getting a place up there in my older age. That would be pretty nice because it seems like a pretty cool place to be during the summer, and they got a couple of shops and restaurants and stuff, so you can work there during the summer and still, you know, go to the beach and hang out. It's a pretty nice place. I enjoyed it. It kind of seemed like, I've never been to California, but it kind of seemed like LA or just a smaller version of it, or any other California city that's near the beach. I usually just think of LA when I think of California. But Long Island is a very nice place, and the beach was very enjoyable. I did not go swimming. My dad did, though. Probably show you some of those pictures because they're pretty funny. But it was pretty cool and enjoyable. I kind of wish I would have taken a time-lapse video of the ocean, because then I could have used that for the background of my ocean view video. However, one super cool thing, there was actually a street in the town called Ocean View. So what do you know? My podcast is already super famous. 3 episodes in and I got a street named after my podcast. That was pretty cool to see that. It was pretty funny too. Tuesday was one of the more enjoyable days. Also, I almost forgot. There was this place we went to, a restaurant, because it was on Tuesday, so we wanted to get tacos for Taco Tuesday. And there was, so we went to a Mexican place. I believe it was called the Cabana. If you're ever up there, you should definitely check it out. I had this taco called the Urban Cowboy Taco. Oh my God, it was so good. It was probably like the best thing I ate up there besides like the family food that we had. Because we grilled a couple times and we had a lot of like family cookout kind of things up there. But besides those things, that fucking taco was so good. It was chicken and bacon and ranch and like 2 different kinds of cheese and lettuce. And oh my God, it was so good. That was very good. I really like New York food. I mean, New Orleans, we have pretty great food, mostly seafood. But New York has a lot of good food like that isn't seafood, you know. The pizza in New York is absolutely amazing. We had pizza like 4 times when we were there. So, the food in New York is pretty great. I'd suggest eating if you ever go on a trip to New York. Food is pretty great. And then moving on to Wednesday, though, that was one of the family things I was talking about. We were at my godmother's house where we were staying, but we invited some people over there that my parents hadn't seen in a while. And we had a grill. We had a cookout and it was pretty enjoyable. We just stayed there the whole day. We didn't go to New York at all, so there wasn't too much going on that day. But Thursday was a pretty busy day. We went to Brooklyn, New York, and we crossed the Brooklyn Bridge and did a lot of stuff over there. That was all pretty fun. I enjoyed being on the bridge. I don't think I've ever walked across a big bridge in New York, really. I mean, we've driven across a bunch. I don't think I've ever been to the Brooklyn Bridge, though. I've been to New York a couple times in my life. Well, a few times. Like, a lot of times, because my grandma lives up there, and that's where my mom's from. So I go to New York every couple years. But I don't remember. I don't think I've ever been to the Brooklyn Bridge, or if I have, I don't remember. That's one thing I liked about this trip, though. I can appreciate stuff more now, because all the buildings and everything around look pretty, like, it's just, it's very, very nice, and it's aesthetically pleasing, I guess. And we got to see the World Trade Center, which I went to last time I was there in 2015. I went to New York, and we got to go up to the World Trade Center. I might be able to find some pictures of that, and put those in here, too, because that was pretty cool. But yeah, I love seeing it from the outside because it's just so, it's a very nice building. I'm glad that it was made. The reason for it being made maybe wasn't the best thing. Well, it definitely was a bad thing, 9/11. But it's nice to see a beautiful building in our country, even though our country's kind of shitty at the moment, being very, it's very divided, but still, it's a very beautiful country, and I'm proud to be here. And I love seeing great places like New York with a lot of history. So yeah, like I said, I've been to New York plenty of times, but I'm glad that I can go there now and appreciate stuff more. And the other thing we did besides going to Brooklyn was we went to the Statue of Liberty. I believe I've been there before, but again, I don't really remember. But it was nice going there. Statue of Liberty is another historical monument, and it's very, it's a very beautiful piece of art. And it's New York has a lot of cool stuff in it, and I'm excited that I got to go see it all and take some good pictures. I was just using my phone, so they weren't, you know, super special, but I thought some of them were pretty good, and I enjoyed them. And then the Thursday night, I kind of did me and my parents had a little super secret thing that we got to do. My mom's cousin works in the building in Times Square where they hold the New Year's Eve ball. Like every New Year's Eve, they drop the ball, countdown to the new year. And we got to see it pretty up close, and I got to see a lot of Times Square, and it was pretty cool seeing it all, and I really enjoyed it. It was kind of a once-in-a-lifetime thing, because not everybody gets to go up there. It's not something like you could pay for, like Statue of Liberty or something. That's kind of a special thing. It's also kind of super secret, so don't tell anybody. But it was very cool, and I loved being up and seeing stuff in Times Square, because Times Square is a pretty nice place to be, especially at night and up high. It was very cool. And then Friday was the last day we did something big. We went, me and my dad went to a Yankees game. And it was the Yankees versus the Red Sox. They're kind of rivals. So, and they're probably like the biggest like rivalry in baseball. So it was pretty fun to see that. And the Yankees actually won the game. There was a point there where they would look like they might lose, but they won. And it was pretty cool. I was very glad to be there because I've always sort of liked baseball a little bit, but I've kind of gotten into it more over the past year or so. And the Cubs are my team, Chicago Cubs. I like them the most, but I kind of like the Yankees second because, you know, my parents like the Yankees. My mom's from New York, like I said, so Yankees are kind of like in my blood, I guess. But it was very fun being there. I really enjoyed it. I'd love to, I'd like to go to Long Island in my old age or something. I'd like to, maybe not my old age, but, you know, like in my 30s or something, if I could. I'd like to get some like baseball tickets or something and go to baseball games more often because it was very fun and enjoyable. I liked it because I've been to like minor league baseball games and stuff like that, but this is my first major league game and it was pretty cool. I like the atmosphere and I like baseball. It's probably my favorite sport because I'm actually interested in it. Even though a lot of people say it's boring and stuff, it can be pretty exciting when stuff happens. So I was glad to be there, and it's a pretty fun atmosphere. If you haven't been to a major league game, I suggest going or trying to go if you can. And it'd be cool if you go to Yankee Stadium because it's a pretty nice stadium. I can't wait to do that again. Hopefully I'll still be doing YouTube or something by then, and I can share that with people then, and maybe I'll have more people who follow me then, and I can share it with everybody because I like sharing cool stuff like that with people, and hopefully they get a chance to do that too, because traveling is pretty cool and vacations are nice, especially for me at the moment because my job is a piece of shit, but that's something else entirely. But I really enjoy my vacation, and I hope you guys enjoy all the pictures and stuff and videos that I took.
Hey, yo, what up? Fuck it, I'll just start like that. I was gonna cut or take a second or whatever, but hi, just making this quick. So here is Ocean View number 3. I recorded this back in 2017, as you could tell from actually watching it, if you did, because I talk about 2017. And I finally edited it. I'm trying to say edited better, because I say edited because I'm a silly man. I edited it this year, 2023. And I cut out the last little bit here because I was just talking about stuff that never happened, about my, you know, schedule and all that. Obviously, it didn't happen since I haven't uploaded in 6 years, but I have a solution to that issue. I made a quick little video that's going to be my channel trailer now for this channel, and it's explaining my thoughts and goals, mainly goals, because I don't know exactly how much I'm gonna do stuff. I'm gonna try my best, but we'll see how what I actually end up doing. And I will also have a longer version of that video, which is a little bit more of a discussion, almost like Ocean View. It's kind of a Ocean View reboot thingy. I don't really know what I'm calling it still, but I talk for a long time like a podcast, and I discuss everything that has happened since 2017, since the last time I recorded anything, which would have been Ocean View number 3 here. So, hope you enjoyed this 6 years late. But if you'd like to find out what I've been up to over the past few years and see what my plans are for the future, please go check out those other videos. And I will be restarting Ocean View as like a new thing, and I actually keep up with it, so let's hope that goes well. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.